I choose to study in China for one big reason. You see, if you see the China and Africa, they have similar history in terms of development process. In economics term, China, although it is well equipped and developed economically, it is still categorized under developing country. That make it very the same with Africa.
The South-South cooperation is quite important for southern countries. China's experience is much closer to other developing countries than Western experience to those countries. So if we increase collaboration and cooperation among ourselves, we are going to be able to exchange similar ideas, similar experience between us.
China has been offering a lot of scholarship, which is a very effective relation, because when you want to change people, there's a saying that you don't give fish to people, but you teach them how to fish. You know, China development, it is with Chinese characteristic, but it is a very step-by-step kind of process. The same thing we as elite need to copy that, but we have to implement it in our own characteristic as well.
China's economic growth just happened over the last 40 years in a really short period of time. You know, so China's experience is fresh. So it's much easier for other countries to learn from. Of course, we don't want them to copy China's experience. They are going to treat China as a mirror, and in the mirror, they're going to see their own countries. Right? So they're going to borrow, not copy, China's growth experience.
Part of the South-South cooperation in the area of human rights, we should convey this message that despite the fact that human rights are indivisible, the right to development should get more attention in the developing world.
We don't have any lesson to learn from the West in terms of human rights. If yes, it can be in terms of sharing. They can have a lesson to teach, but they can also have a lesson to learn from human rights in our countries.
We need voices from developing countries, because the whole world system is just dominated by the West. Different countries have different cultural roots, different historical heritages, and we have to respect them. Right? We should not impose just one model of growth, or one model of political system, one model of human rights to all countries. We should allow those countries to determine what are important rights people should have for their own purpose.
It's very important to have one cooperation between all the countries to defend all the human rights, because it's part of the life, it's part of the progress, is part of all the development of the countries.
China is taking the lead among southern countries in order to stop some of the misconceptions and the northern dominance in the debate on human rights. Southern countries should converge, and China is taking the initiative. So I applaud that decision very much.
The South-South Human Rights Forum just provides an equal table for all countries from Global South to speak out, and then to envision a brighter future for their own countries.